Hi, my name is Greg Narayan, and today I'm going to show you how to make your own logo like this one we see right here on my website. When I looked on YouTube for tutorials like this one, all I found were ways to make a logo or create a logo in Photoshop or Illustrator and so on, and that's crazy. I'm sure these logos are great, but you don't need to know how to use Photoshop or Illustrator or pay hundreds of dollars for those softwares in order to make your own logo. And today I'm going to show you how to do it for free and also to do it correctly in terms of copyright. All right, so the first thing we want to do is open up your Google, your browser. You just need a web browser and a computer to do this tutorial. And visit logomaker.com. That's L-O-G-O-M-A-K-R without the E.com. All right, then click away and just click onto the white to get rid of the notifications. And now we're going to make our logo. All right, so the first thing we need is some text. You can click the T on the left to bring up a text editor, and then we can just start typing. And of course, you could write whatever it is you want, like, you know, something cool or whatever you have in mind. Once you click away from the text, it will deselect it. And if you hover back and click, you can select it again. Once you've selected the text, come up to the drop-down menu where it says Font Family and choose a font that suits your business or your brand. To change the color of the text, we can move our mouse to the lower right-hand corner and we can just click anywhere on the color wheel. As long as we have the text selected, that color will show up. And if you have a specific 6-digit color hex in mind, you can just paste that in right here and it'll start showing up on top of your text. All right, now we need an image to go next to our text. So click away, and then let's search graphics. Click in the search graphics bar, and search for the right graphic that you might want. And there are hundreds to choose from. So as you can see, this gets really fun. Don't get overwhelmed by all the options, but make sure you pick something that suits your brand and is simple enough for people to remember. When you find an icon graphic you like, you can just hover over it and click once to bring it into your logo canvas. And then you can click to drag so it's in the right position. And then you can click on the corners to resize it. And it will resize proportionally, but if you press shift and drag, you can make it however you want. If you don't like a change you made, just hit control or command Z to undo and drag it back into place. And of course, resize it. You can also change the color of your icon in the same way you change the text color. Just make sure it's selected and click on the right-hand side in the color wheel. Make sure your items are spaced enough that people can read everything that you're creating. And once you're ready, click on the crop button in the lower right corner. Just click crop. Logo Maker will understand how big your logo is, hopefully, but if they don't, you can just drag it in a little more. And then just click enter. I'm just going to click enter. Once our logo is cropped, we need to click on the floppy disk to save logo. And then make sure this window stays open and click on this little button where it says click here to copy credits. Just click that once. And I'm going to show you where to put those credits once you copy them. Now come back to your website, and it's particularly easy to upload a logo if you're using a WordPress website because you don't need to know any code and can do it yourself. But if you're using an old-fashioned website with HTML and CSS, this will work fine. And if you're using any other kind of website, this should work fine too. We're just going to use a WordPress website right here. All right, let's click to the dashboard. All right, and if you're familiar with WordPress, then this should be fine. And if not, then you can always ask me any questions about it. I'm happy to help. We first want to go to Pages. And in Pages, you got to create a Credits page. You can just click Add New and then title a page Credits. And then you'll have this little option right here. So I'm going to open my existing Credits page and make some space. We're in the Text tab because we're pasting in a little section of HTML from the site that we made the logo on. That's Logo Maker. And we're just going to paste it in. All right, so it looks like this. And if you're in the Visual tab and you do that and you hit paste, then it'll just generate a little bit funny. And that's why you want to be in the Text tab. All right, once you insert your credits, you're all set to go and you're compliant with the copyrights of this icon and that text, you're good to go. We just need to update this page and then insert the link to this page somewhere on the site where people can find it. Now to insert your logo to your website, just hover on Appearance and click Customize. This is all really easy and just how a professional web designer would do it, by the way. And in this particular theme called North, we're going to navigate to Theme Settings, Branding, and I'm going to remove this logo because I've looked at it too much and I'm sick of it. Just click Remove, and then click Select File. All right, and now I'm gonna rename the logo. I'm gonna open Finder on my Mac, but you might have a different way of finding files on your Windows or PC. And I always like renaming the logos. So you should rename it to a good name that you'll remember, of course. All right, close. Now we're gonna click Select Files. And WordPress will find that logo we just renamed. We just need to go to our downloads folder, find it, select it, and click open. And now once we do that, the logo will be on your website, and we just need to click choose file. And that will insert the logo onto our website. Next, just click save and publish, and you should be good to go. We can preview the logo in this screen right here in the customize area. And when we X out, we can hopefully see the logo looking good on our site. Let's click back to the home page. And voila, you've now created your own custom logo for free without any Photoshop or design skills and without having to go find a web designer in your town and pay them to do it. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you found it useful, you could please comment and like it and share it with your friends so that they can make logos for free too. I'd really appreciate it, and thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.